Let's wrap up the week in corporate stories. Mary Mart Wholesale marks a milestone as it reaches over 200,000 registered members. The supermarket operator reports it now has 127 branches and its super app is seeing growth in users. The e-commerce platform of Ed Garcia's Mary Mart is also eyeing to grow its customer base to 500,000 this year. Two utilities now, Converge ICT, ramping up its fiber internet offerings to customers. It says users with a monthly plan of 300 or 3,500 pesos can now enjoy internet speeds of 1 gigabyte per second. Users with its lowest plan of 1,500 pesos can also surf the web at 300 megabytes per second. No additional payments are required, although Converge says the boost will last only until the end of March. And finally, Now Corporation enters into a deal with New York's VA to bring in private wireless LAN solutions to the local market. Now Corp says the agreement will enhance its existing connectivity framework tailored for the enterprise market. This will also allow the two companies to explore tech solutions that will promote community development. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. vows to continue government support for the Philippine creative industry. He spoke Friday at the National Museum of Fine Arts in Manila for the 50th year of the country's design center. Marcos notes the design and creative industries have contributed trillions of pesos to the economy and generated thousands of jobs for Filipinos. Mr. Marcos says they will push for laws to help designers improve in their craft and elevate Philippine art to the global level. The Philippines marks National Arts Month this February.
We are implementing forward-thinking legislation and other policies to promote and to promote innovation, to support entrepreneurship, and to protect intellectual property. These initiatives aim to amplify the economic and cultural significance of the creative sector, empowering Filipino designers to flourish, further hone their craft, and to shine internationally.
And the Metro Manila Council is set to tackle a proposed resolution to regulate electric bicycles and tricycles on major thoroughfares. Victor Nunez, head of the Metro Manila Development Authority's Traffic Enforcement Group, says transport regulators have actually set guidelines for areas where e-bikes and e-trikes can traverse back in 2021. But a technical working group believes penalties should be imposed since these vehicles appear to be driven on major roads by unlicensed drivers. Nunez adds the penalties are still subject to approval by the MMC next week.
Kasi po, it's high time kasi marami na rin yung nag-trending sa social media. Nakita nyo naman, nasa South Superhighway, nasa SLEX, nakakapasok yung mga e-trikes. So, hindi naman namin talaga ito dinidiscriminate. We just need to regulate it para naman po ang main namin dito is to promote road safety kasi napakadelikado po itong mga ganitong uri ng sasakyan na makikita sa mga national roads at major thoroughfares.
The Philippine Education Department and Higher Education Commission were the most trusted state agencies in the fourth quarter of 2023. That's according to the OCTA Research Group's Tugon ng Masa or TNM survey. OCTA says DepEd earned a trust rating of 84%. While CHED earned 83%. Other trusted agencies include the Social Welfare Department and the Health Department. CHED Chairperson Prospero De Vera III says the survey results attest to his commission's effective services and programs. The TNM survey interviewed some 1,200 respondents from December 10 to 14 last year.